Myself is Satyajit Dhar, Senior Lecturer Life and Science. I am taking Engineering Chemistry classes. Today we will discuss about Faraday's laws of inoculations. Faraday's laws of inoculations. Faraday's laws of inoculations means it is of two laws. First, we will discuss about fast food. From inoculations, we found that by inoculations of a salt, at the electrons, metals are deposited or gases are released. So, how there is a quantitative relationship between the amount of the substance deposited and quantitative relationship passed through their solution, that is quantitatively explained by Faraday's first law of inoculations. The law states that the amount of a substance deposited at an electron is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through its solution. So again, one second, repeat the law. So according to the law, during the electrolysis process, the amount of a substance deposited or liberated at an electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through its aqueous or molten state. This is the theoretical definition statement. Now we find its mathematical form. Let during inoculations W amount of a substance is deposited by the passage of q coulomb of electricity. So we take how much amount of the substance is deposited, W gram of the substance is deposited by the passage of q coulomb of electricity through its solution. So by putting these values according to this statement, we will find the mathematical expression. So what is the expression according to this? Now according to the law, we get W proportional to Q. And again, according to Ohm's law, Q is equal to IT. So we can write W proportional to IT, where I stands for current in ampere and T stands for time in second. So now to make it equal, we have to multiply it with the constants. So our expression will be W is equal to ZIT. This is the mathematical expression for first law of inoculations. And in this expression, W stands for amount of the substance deposited. Already we have discussed I stands for amount of current strength in ampere and T stands for time in second. The new term here is Z. That is most important. Here Z stands for, it is the proportionality constant and called as electrochemical equivalent of the substance. So this is very important term. Many multiple choice questions related to Z, problems related to Z are found. So note these things first of all, then we start another part of this law, how to calculate the amount quantitative. So here just as for electrochemical equivalent of the substance, we can write it short as ECE of the substance. So sometimes the question is about define ECE, how to define electrochemical equivalent. Definition of ECE, electrochemical equivalent exact. Now we get W is equal to ZIE, when I will be equal to 1 ampere and T will be equal to 1 second, then W will be equal to Z. So from this you can define electrochemical equivalent as what? So electrochemical equivalent is the amount of substance deposited by the passage of one ampere of current for 1 second. This is the definition of electrochemical equivalent. Note it down. Note all these points. Then we start the further part. So now this is all about the first part of electrolysis. It explains the quantitative relationship between the amount of a substance deposited and the amount of current passed through its solution and the time for which the current is passed. Next is how to calculate Z of a substance. Calculation of Z means ECE of a substance. So now we get first one, now we get W is equal to Z cube. So directly we can find out that Z will be W by Q. If in the problem directly amount of the substance deposited is given and amount of the electricity passed is given, so directly by using this relation we can find out the value of Z. Second, we found out W is equal to ZIT. So Z will be equal to W by IT. So if in the problem data is in the form of current strength and time, we can use this relation to find out the value of Z. These two are directly from the law. These two equations, these two relations we find derived directly from the law. There is another one that is important, how to find out. Now before that we define 1 Faraday of electricity. What do you find? 1 Faraday of electricity. Now what is it? Now it is the amount of charge carried by 1 mole of electrons. So 1 Faraday of electricity is defined as the amount of charge carried by 1 mole of electrons. So charge of 1 electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19 coulomb. So charge of 1 mole of electrons will be equal to 61023 into 10 to the 23 into 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19. This will be nearly equal to 96500 coulomb. So we get 1 Faraday of electricity is equal to 96500. Now we relate this one to the electrochemical equivalent and also to the chemical equivalent of a substance. What is that? Now it is found that one Faraday of electricity deposits 1 gram equivalent, one equivalent of a soft ox. That is, one farad deposits is equal to 1 gram equivalent. That is, 965,000 coulomb deposits is equal to 1 gram equivalent. So, 1 coulomb will deposit is equal to 1 gram equivalent by 965,000. And this 1 gram equivalent is simply equal to the chemical equivalent of the substance. That is equal to chemical equivalent by 965,000. And by definition, this is the amount deposited by 1 coulomb of electricity. So by definition, this is equal to Z. Because electrochemical equivalent is the amount deposited by the passage of 1 ampere of current for 1 second or by the passage of 1 coulomb of electricity. So we get a relation. That is also asked as a short question. What is this? ECE, electrochemical equivalent, is related to chemical equivalent by the relation chemical equivalent by 965,000. Now, chemical equivalent is equal to atomic mass by valence. So we get Z is equal to atomic mass by valence. Now putting this relation in Faraday's expression, we will get a very simple equation to determine the amount deposited. Our equation was W is equal to ZIT. So that we simplify it. In place of Z, we can write A by V into this is 96500, A into I into T by V into 96500. So by using this relation, we can calculate the amount of a substance deposited at an electron by the passage of I ampere of current for T seconds. Here all the terms are clear. The A stands for atomic mass. That will be given in the sub problem, or you remember this up to 30 elements. I stands for current strength. T stands for time second. V stands for valence of that substance or valence of that metal. This is all about Faraday's first law of electrolysis. So in the next session, we'll do some numericals related to this part. Thanks for watching.